everyone, this is Mindy Egan, and in today's video, we are going to be creating a hearts background for our Valentine wreath. Here's a look at the products that I'll be using today from Pretty Pink Posh. This is the Scattered Hearts Stencil and the Valentine Wreath Stamp Set. I'm going to start first by creating my background. I am working on Nina Solar White 80-pound white cardstock, and I have this placed on top of my waffle flower stencil mat. I started by ink blending Spun Sugar Distress Oxide ink about a third of the way down, and then I'm bringing in Worn Lipstick. Next, I kind of flipped my cardstock, so I'm always kind of blending from the top. That's just my natural way of ink blending. And now I'm bringing in Picked Raspberry. I'm going to blend that Picked Raspberry down into the Worn Lipstick to kind of help smooth out that transition. And then I'm going to bring in my Spun Sugar once again, just to kind of help that transition down there as well, so it isn't such a stark line. By going over it a couple times, it really does help smooth out those colors. Then I'm going to bring in my hearts stencil. I'm going to place that over my background, and then I'm going to pick both of these up and flip that over and just hold that down with some Post-it tape. I have been enjoying working on the media mat because it is a silicone mat, so it holds my cardstock in place, but I still need to secure my stencil to the card front. Then I'm blending on Wilted Violet and Picked Raspberry over those heart areas. This is going to create a beautiful contrast on our light background. Now, since I had used Distress Oxide inks and they are reactive to water, I really do like to splatter my backgrounds. So I'm just putting a little bit of water down on my mat. I'm going to pick that up with my paintbrush and just tap my paintbrush all over that background. This just adds a little bit of subtle interest, and I'm going to come back later on and add just a little bit more. Now I can work on my stamping and my coloring. So this is the wreath from the Valentine Wreath Stamp Set. I have here a piece of 80-pound Nina Solar White cardstock, and I'm just going to stamp this image down onto the cardstock. Now I didn't prep my image before stamping, which means I didn't clean it and I didn't rub my hand over it. So I'm not getting a very good impression the first time. So I stamped it about two or three more times in Copic Friendly ink. You really do want to prep your stamps before stamping. It just gives you a lot cleaner of an impression. Since I stamped in a Copic Friendly ink, I am going to color these with my Copic markers. I am not doing any shading to any of these images. I have all of the colors that I used listed at the top of the screen, and all I really did was try and create that visual triangle. So that's how the images are laid out. If you notice the key or the bow and arrow, they're kind of visually laid out in a triangle. So I'm doing that also with my colors. I have some different shades of pink and reds. I added a little bit of that turquoise to my cupcakes just to add a little bit of a different color to this whole thing other than the reds and the pinks. But I'm just straight coloring with my markers. I'm not doing any shading. Once I have everything all colored in, I'm going to bring in the coordinating die and line that up with the image. Then I can hold that down with a low tack tape and die cut this. Also included on the Valentine Wreath stamp set are some sentiments, which is what I have here loaded in my Misti tool. I'm stamping this in a white pigment ink onto black cardstock. Now I did prep my cardstock with an anti-static powder tool, and I really love stamping in a white pigment ink when I'm going to do white heat embossing. It just gives me a more complete look. I feel like I get better results by this. They do take a little bit more to clean your stamp off because it is pigment, so it stays wet a little longer, but I think it is totally worth it. So I'm sprinkling on that white embossing powder, tapping off the excess, and then melting that with my heat tool. Now there is also a coordinating die for these sentiments as well, which I love. So I'm die cutting that out too, and I'll set that off on the side to work on my background just a little bit. I decided I wanted to add some gold flicks to this background. There's just something about a Valentine's card with gold in it. So I'm bringing in my Starry watercolors, added a little bit of water, and then flicked that over my background as well. After my background is dry, I am going to finish putting my card together. So I put some foam squares behind my wreath and then centering that on the front of my card. And I'm also going to add some black foam squares behind my sentiment. This fits perfectly inside of that wreath, and I really love that pop of black in there with all of those pinks. I'm going to add just a little bit more sparkle to the front of my card by taking a Nouveau Shimmer pen and just adding that over some of the larger images. That will finish off my card today. I hope this video has inspired you to use your stencil and your Valentine wreath stamp set. I want to thank you so much for joining me today. All of the supplies used will be listed down below in the video description. Thanks!